Ah, yes, my beautiful spreadsheets. Hello, and welcome back to another episode of Money with Min. Today, we're going to be talking about taxes. And with the U.S. tax season coming to a close in a few weeks, I don't know about you, but I still got to do my taxes. Let me know in the comments below whether you got a tax refund this year or whether you actually owe the government some money. And if you watch to the end of this video, you'll get a better sense of understanding the black box that is taxes, as well as how tax refunds are calculated. And this video was actually inspired by a conversation with a very close friend of mine where we were talking about taxes and tax refunds. And we were wondering why he had to pay the government while I got a tax refund myself. So I got curious and I made a special spreadsheet just for this video. And if you stay to the end, I'll share a link with you below. So let's get to that spreadsheet I made just for you this very morning. Ah, yes, my beautiful spreadsheets. And before we get into how this spreadsheet works, I wanted to provide some information up top about the tax brackets, both from the federal perspective as well as the state perspective. And in my case, it's California. And I'll link a quick video up top here explaining how tax brackets work because people often get it wrong. And while it's true, if you make a buttload of money, you're gonna be taxed more, but you're not gonna be taxed entirely at the highest percentage. Instead, the brackets here are what dictates how much money you get taxed at which rates based upon your income level. So from an IRS perspective, if you make a little bit of money, you're going to be taxed 10% of that. But if you make a lot more money, then you're going to be taxed at higher rates based upon the incremental addition of what your income is. And the same goes for tax brackets, which varies by state, with California being one of the higher states in the US. And if you live in California and you make over, you know, $600,000 here, which is the highest tax bracket, well, firstly, good for you, you're doing well. But all that money that you make above $600,000 is actually taxed the highest bracket, which is 12.3%. And something I've started seeing within the YouTube and creator space is that YouTubers and influencers who actually live in California are starting to move out of the state because they're trying to avoid this high tax. So now that we have a quick primer on tax brackets, let's get into the spreadsheet, let's get into the calculations, let's get into the formulas. And one other thing to remember is that the income level for your tax brackets depends whether you're filing as a single person, married filing jointly, and some other scenarios, but I kept it as married and single for simplicity in this video. So for instance, if you're filing as a single person and your income level is between $40,000 and $85,000, you're roughly at about a 22% highest bracket. Conversely, if you're married and you can make between $80,000 and $170,000, and the range within there is also at the 22% bracket. But then again, remember, the more money you make, the incremental income is actually taxed at a higher bracket the more money you make. So all right, let's get to the spreadsheet and check out the custom formulas that I made just for you this afternoon. So if you want to check out this spreadsheet yourself, I'll provide a link down below so you can grab your own copy. Of course, this is set up for California residents only. And if you want to do your own version for your state, you can tweak this a little bit and make it work for you. So let me go through the spreadsheet for you. So the input variables on this spreadsheet are highlighted in blue for you. So these are the cells that you'll input your information into. And in this first example, this single person is pulling in $100,000 as their gross income. And this is before any deductions from their paychecks, any 401ks, anything of that nature. And if you've been following my channel at all, you should be putting some money into your 401k, at least the amount of the employer match, if not the entire IRS maximum of $19,500. And why this is important is if you are contributing the max of $19,500 into your traditional 401k, that actually reduces the amount of taxable income that the IRS can tax you with. Another important thing I'm including here is the standard deduction amount from the IRS as it applies to your taxes. And this number is currently $12,400 that gets automatically deducted from your income to calculate your adjusted income. And I put another line here for other deductions that might apply to your tax situation, such as if you have a traditional IRA contribution every year, mortgage interest, child credits, your HSA, etc. But you can add any other tax deductions that might apply to your tax situation in this cell here. This person's also contributing $6,000 to his traditional IRA, which is also helping reduce his tax liability. So in this person's example, someone who makes $100,000 a year, after they deduct their $19,500 from their 401k, after they deduct their $12,400 standard deduction, and $6,000 in other deductions, their adjusted taxable income is only $62,100. And this is often called the AGI or the MAGI when you're doing your taxes, but this is adjusted gross income or modified adjusted gross income. But essentially the $62,000 is what you'll be taxed on, as opposed to this $100,000 of your gross income. So this is why I stress to you as my viewer to take note of whatever tax deductions you can take advantage of. Specifically, the 401k maximum deduction of $19,500 is huge depending on what your income level is. Again, I've simplified this. Your taxes might be a bit different. The actual calculations might be a little bit more nuanced. So let's get to the part on how we calculate the actual taxes based upon your adjusted taxable income. As a disclosure, I'm not a tax expert. I'm far, far from being a CPA. I'm just a random dude on the internet who happens to know numbers very well and knows how to use Excel. So if you want more information on this in more detail, go find an accountant, go find a CPA, and they'll teach you a lot more about this stuff as well. So back to our example, with an adjusted income of $62,100, this person will be paying $9,452 in federal taxes and $2,904 in California taxes. So this person's effective tax rate at the federal level is 15.2%, and it's 4.7% at the state level. And to go one level deeper, this is actually how the taxes are calculated within each bracket. So again, let's take that $62,100, which I've put here, and this is more of the formulas down below this line. So let's check this out. So at $62,100, this person's adjusted income will span across the first three tax brackets at the federal level. So for instance, the first $9,875 is taxed at only 10%. So this is how much they're paying there. And the same thing happens for the second bracket, which is another $30,000 taxed at 12% for $3,600. And then the final bracket this person fits into has a $21,975 increment for a taxable $4,835. So in total at the federal level, that's $9,452, as you can see here. And that's what they're paying in federal. The same exact explanation can apply to the state level of taxes. But at $62,000, this person spans across multiple tax brackets here in California. They're pretty evenly spread out here. But overall, this person owes $2,904 to the state. So now the question is, how do tax refunds work? If you're working for a company and you're getting a weekly paycheck, you're likely getting automatic tax withholdings and deductions from your paycheck each and every time. And over the course of the year, that accumulates to the amount that you paid the IRS automatically through your paycheck. When the whole calendar year is done, you'll have paid the IRS automatically through your paycheck. And sometimes you pay the IRS too much, then you trigger a tax refund. And sometimes you actually don't pay the government enough, so you owe the government during tax season. And in this example, W-2, this person is making $48,500. And with an automatic federal income tax withheld of $6,835. Now, depending on the adjusted gross income of this individual and the taxes they owe, let's say they did their taxes, and let's say they actually owe the federal government $6,000, which means that they overpaid by $835 throughout the year, so they'll be getting a refund. But let's say, for instance, they actually owe $7,500, then they'll owe the government $665 when tax season comes around. Now let's go through an example for my married couples out there. And if you're married filing jointly, I'm gonna go through the example with high income earners. So let's say you are a power couple who's making a ton of money, and let's say you're pulling in $350,000 in income as a married couple. Good for you. If you're doing this right, and you're listening to my channel and you're a viewer here, both of you definitely should be maxing out your 401ks if you have them. So that would be a $39,000 401k deduction. And if you're also a high income earner out there, you definitely should be maxing out your 401k every year because there's very little reasons not to. Again, the standard deduction comes into play with $24,800 for a couple. And let's say there's other deductions in play here, whether it's IRAs, other deductions, child credits, whatever it is. But let's say this couple has another $12,000 in deductions. So from their $350,000 gross income, their adjusted taxable income is now only $274,200, which ends up being their MAGI for the tax calculation. So of course, with this married couple making a lot more money than the single individual in the first example, they'll be paying a lot more taxes. So the taxes they're paying here are $53,967 at the federal level, which is an effective tax rate of 19.7%. And for CA taxes, they're gonna be paying $19,758 for an effective tax rate of 7.2%. So let me show you something that's interesting here before I show you the calculations below. Let's say this couple isn't actually contributing to their 401k to the maximum extent. Let's say they're only doing the minimum to get the employer match, which is a fair strategy, but let's check out what that looks like. So let's say they are putting in $10,000 a year. And while I hit enter, check out how that number below changes in taxes. So they're paying a lot more in taxes, as you can see. So it's jumped up almost $7,000 here and $3,000 there. So again, I emphasize how important it is to invest and max out your 401k if your budget allows for it. And to quickly break down this $53,000 and this $19,000 in taxes, again, this is how the brackets are broken up down below. So this married couple spans across four different tax brackets, all the way up to the 24% tax bracket, as you can see here. And if they made a little bit more money from a adjustable gross income perspective and they hit past this bracket, anything they made above $326,000 would actually be taxed at 32%. So to quickly cover the California state tax brackets, pretty similar again, but one thing to note here is as with this married couple making this level of income, they actually hit the 9.3% bucket, which a lot of individuals do, but this range is pretty big between $117,000 to $599,000. So a huge chunk of taxes is actually coming from this bracket. If they're making more than $600,000, they'd be starting to pay 10%. And for the mega rich families and couples in California making over $1.2 million a year in income, they're gonna be taxed at over 12.3%. And going back to the summary for the married couple, this is how much they owe in taxes. So depending on how much withholdings and automatic withdrawals they've had from their paychecks and how much they paid the government throughout the year, they might get a refund or they might owe, but it all pivots around these two numbers. And one final thing to discuss here is that it's ideal to actually not owe the government any money, obviously, but also you don't want a huge refund either. Getting a huge tax refund actually means that you've been overpaying the government with every paycheck, and you could have actually been using that money instead for investments or other things in your life. And there's actually tons of other ways to reduce your tax liability every year, and we'll cover some of those approaches and strategies in future videos. Again, a link to the spreadsheet is down in the description below. I made it just for you, so definitely check it out and put in your numbers and see how this turns out. So let me know in the comments below if you have any other tax loopholes or tax strategies that reduces your income and ultimately reduces your tax bill at the end of the year. If you enjoyed this video or learned something today, please do me a favor and hit that like button. It definitely helps me out. It helps this channel grow. And of course, if you want to see more weekly videos on how to get wiser with your money, definitely consider subscribing. And as always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.